potatoes.
When potatoes first came to Europe in the 16th century, they were not very popular. You got this lumpy, starchy, bland food that grows in dirt, and it's from another land? Not gonna happen. But when potatoes were sold as an aphrodisiac, a sort of natural Viagra, people lined down the cobbled streets to get a taste. It's crazy how little things, little changes, can make something that much more desirable. It's not true, by the way. Potatoes are not an aphrodisiac. So what can we do with these potatoes? Well, I want to cook them up, but first I have to peel them and slice them. But the traditional route, using your handy dandy knife, takes quite a while, and I'd rather try out a new technique that I saw on a different YouTube channel, where essentially you take your potato and give it a nice hard whack. Wow, and that actually worked. So let's take this and fry it up. Fried to a crisp. Yep, slice it up, cook it in some oil, and you've got yourself potato chips. I like potato chips because they're full of salt, carbs, fat. They taste good is what I'm trying to say. But surprisingly, there seems to be something else that draws us to potato chips. They're addictive almost. And there's evidence to support this. A group of researchers did an experiment where they fed rats three different types of food. The regular kind of food, a food that matched the high fat and high carbohydrate content of potato chips, and then just straight potato chips. They found that even though the high-fat, high-carb food was practically identical to the makeup of potato chips, the rats still ate more potato chips than anything else. But why? Well, there may be some unidentified molecule in potato chips that makes them so much more tempting. But I think that there's a simpler explanation, a phenomenon that explains it all, the parchment skin illusion. The parchment skin illusion was discovered back in the 90s during an experiment. People were brought into a booth, given a pair of noise-canceling headphones, and asked to rub their hands together. While doing this, the researcher manipulated the frequencies to either be louder or quieter. What they found is that louder, high-frequency participants thought their hands felt much drier, and quieter, high-frequency participants thought their hands felt more moist. That's crazy, right? You can test this out at home yourself, actually. All you need is a pair of earplugs that block out most noise. Put them in.
Okay, now find a piece of unfinished wood and run your finger over it. Okay, feels pretty smooth. Now, take out the earplugs
and feel it again. Seems a bit rougher, huh? This essentially shows that sound dramatically influences our sense of touch. So, what's that got to do with potato chips? Well, they're fun to eat. They're light, thin, and crispy. You can grab one or a whole handful at a time. They let off a distinct and pleasing aroma, and they crunch in your mouth and break apart so nicely. This makes potato chips a sort of supersensory food. They stimulate all sensations. There's actually tons of studies all about potato chips and ranking them based on things like color, texture, and loudness of crunch. And scientists like Charles Spence have used the parchment skin illusion specifically to show how sound influences how fresh, crisp, and tasty a chip seems. But scientists aren't the only ones who know this. Companies that make chips are also aware of the phenomenon and use it to their advantage. The more appealing a chip, the more chips you eat, the more chips you buy, and the more cash they make. That is why practically all chips come in this kind of packaging. It's crinkly, crunchy almost, sort of like a potato chip. That's right, this is no coincidence. This kind of packaging actually makes potato chips seem fresher, crisper, and crunchier than chips that are not served in crinkly plastic. It just sounds better and therefore tastes better. So the next time you want to avoid the guilt of eating an entire bag of salt and vinegar chips by yourself, pour it into a bowl. Okay, now for something completely different. My good friend Inés Dawson over at Draw Curiosity came up with the idea of doing this potato collaboration after a cute kid asked her what kind of potato would make the best battery. Well, today, I'm gonna put my homegrown red potatoes to the test with my voltmeter and see who comes out on top. Here we go. Okay, so I have my supplies. Let me show you what I got.
Potato.
It'll focus. A nice shiny penny. And then I've got this nail, which is made out of zinc. Hopefully it works. It's not galvanized, which is what they recommend. If not, I have this kind of rough zinc hook as well that we'll see if that works. If the nail doesn't, putting it together is really easy. Take your penny, stick it in one side, like so. And then you take your nail, and at least an inch apart, I'm gonna do it more than an inch, you stick that in as well. Boom. Easy enough. So I've got my voltmeter here turned on. We're gonna see if this is putting out any power yet. All right, help me out. You see anything?
0.1, what is that? We need more power than that.
We're gonna take out the nail. We're gonna try out this little washer thingy. And we're gonna see if that's any better.
0.5, 0.6, right around there.
That is a lot better. I'm not really sure how I stack up to the other YouTubers yet, but hopefully I win. I don't want to make it competitive or anything like that. I don't have a chip on my shoulder. I am sure we'll hash it out. This really makes me sound like an agitator. Seriously though, if you want to learn more about potatoes, please check out the collaboration videos. I'm going to put a link to the playlist in the corner and also in the description so you can check it out. There's some really awesome people on there, people who you probably don't even know about, so jump on it. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos in the future. I promise there are no more potato puns. Thanks to our Patreon supporters for believing in us and giving us real money for the work that we do. And until next time, I'm Micah. Think about it.